The Uganda Wildlife Conservation Education Center's Executive Director, Dr. James Musinguzi, has revealed that the shoebill stork is so endangered, yet it is one of the most loved birds in the country. Currently, Uganda has 2,000 shoebill birds left. Therefore, more efforts are needed to protect them.
Stork is an endangered bird. We have more than 1,000, estimated to be around 2,000 left in the country. And therefore, as the Uganda Wildlife Conservation Education Center, we are putting a lot of efforts in conserving the shoebill stork because it is one of the birds that is attracting tourists to Uganda. In addition to the captive environment where we are keeping the shoebills here and offering conservation education about the shoebill, we are also working in situ in Makanaga wetland ecosystem by promoting ecotourism in that area. We have worked with the communities and set up trails. We have supported them to set up signage and beautification of the place so that we can always refer tourists and visitors who visit UWEC.
He's urged the community to appreciate the value of the shoebill and avoid killing them because they're a source of foreign exchange.
The communities to appreciate the value of the shoebill so that once they get them caught up in their nets, they are not killed or they are not sold in wildlife trafficking. We therefore are working with the communities to make sure that the shoebill is conserved using a two-pronged approach through conservation education, both here at the zoo in Entebbe, but also in the communities of Makanaga, but also promotion of ecotourism so that the communities in Makanaga can appreciate the value of the shoebill by them earning some money through running tourism experiences in that area.
Been here and I've had an experience with the shoebill, but yes, it's one of the species that we have to protect in this world, and we are proud to say that the biggest number in the wild is in Uganda. So for the birders, the tourists that come for birding, that is one of the pulls to this destination. So we must continue preserving the environment.
Alapo Babra, an animal curator at UWEC, says the shoebill likes to live in wetlands. She's urged people to avoid destruction of wetlands to ensure the shoebill is protected.
The shoebill storks are highly solitary birds living in wetlands, and a lot of people who go to look for them spend hours in the wetlands looking for these birds to see them. They are one of the major attractions that Uganda has, and that means they contribute a good percentage to the tourism industry, and also this calls for their conservation.
Major General George A. Owino, Kenya's High Commissioner to Uganda, said visiting UWEC is a good experience since it has a variety of animals. He's appealed to people to protect the environment because it has the breeding centers for the birds.
I don't know, we're not sure of what you're going to see, but it's such an experience. I come to Entebbe, but I've not come to this wonderful place. And more so with the explanations from him about the animals, where they come from, and understanding that it's a rescue center, not just a zoo, it's a rescue center where animals that are found in distress are brought. I think it's a wonderful place to be in, and I'm sure we'll be having more of this.
Dr. James Musinguzi, the Uganda Wildlife Conservation Education Center, has called upon different dignitaries and people from all walks of life to always visit the center. He says this will help promote the tourism sector.
Experiences that we are providing, because we feel that every Kenyan visitor who comes to Uganda through the embassy should be able to visit the zoo in Entebbe, because it is a great place, and so we are using all means to market our center and Uganda in general. So it has been a privilege to host the Kenyan High Commissioner to Uganda, who has appreciated the behind-the-scenes experience and has actually recommended it to other visitors, and he's going to recommend more visitors to come and do the same experience. So it's a great opportunity because we want to penetrate the Kenyan market. We want to make sure that UWEC goes beyond the borders of Uganda, beginning with our neighbors in the East African community. And so bringing the Kenyan High Commissioner to UWEC is great for, as far as achieving our aspiration of marketing Uganda and UWEC is concerned.
Shoebill storks live for 35 years. They feed on fish and frogs, among others. Land reclamation and swamp degradations are affecting the existence of the shoebill storks. Report by Godfrey Sempija for the news.